In recent weeks, folks here in the Payload Operations Integration Center have been busy with Robonaut activities. Now, Robonaut is a humanoid designed to perform simple, repetitive, or even dangerous crew tasks. Now, for some, it's a technology demonstration for robotics, while others, he's all too real. I spoke with someone who really knows Robonaut. Tell us about Robonaut. How are things going?
Things are going great with Robonaut. Robonaut 2 is an upper body humanoid. It's on the International Space Station. We are just about to send up legs to make it mobile to go around and do really interesting science research and hopefully help out the crew with different tasks and things that it's going to do.
Now, as avionics and systems, you're kind of the heart of the matter, right? You get to tell it to do the cool stuff.
Rewrite all of the control systems as well as the applications. So some of the things that I'm really interested in working on, what we've been doing is on Space Station right now, we have several different tasks that we do, such as the cleaning handrails, wipe manipulation, soft goods manipulation, taking blankets off of products to show that we can do that sort of task EVA so that the big robots can then grab onto the different or use the replacement units outside the station, as well as doing things like inventory tasks. We have a cargo bag in front of us, and we're going to scan that with the RFID tag reader and do some simple inventory tasks that the astronauts spend a lot of time doing on the station.
So do you look at Robonaut 2 as another crew member? Is he almost human to you? How do you look at him?
He's completely human to me, but I spend a lot of time with him. We appreciate the fact that the crew members seem to also kind of take the little brother approach with Robonaut, and that, you know, they treat it like a crew member as well. We hope to be much more like a crew member. The things that we're learning right now on a stanchion they're going to help us when we have it go mobile and then be able to do things. And so when we're actually contributing to the crew, we think that they will hopefully consider it even more part of the member of their crew.
So In the time that Robonaut has been up there, what is something fascinating that you learned that maybe you didn't know you were going to see?
There have been so many interesting things. So the first thing, we send up this robot. It's an upper body. It's doing things in the lab that we like that it's doing. It's working great. We have a partnership with General Motors, and they're happy with what we're doing. We're safe around humans. We're able to do real work. We're able to, you know, do the tasks that we expect on Earth. And then we send it to the space station, and we're like, wow, this is so much different. We're operating it, you know, over thousands of miles away, and it's got different tasks that we want it to do. And so we've actually redone the entire control system of Robonaut. We are keeping the safety around humans. That's a really important part of it. But we're adding a lot more precision. We're adding a lot more things that real manipulators and factories can do, the real precision stuff. What the nice thing is we're combining that with our torque control safety. And so it's this amazing robot that you can only find one place, you know, out of the world or in the world to really be able to combine those two things. And so I think that's been the neatest thing, is that we've really had to step it up in figuring out how to control this robot so that it can work around crew but do it in an efficient manner.
Now, as you say, the legs are going up. So what new tasks can we see with that? What's going to make that different, other than making it look more human?
So everything we've done so far is basically research in these technology applications and understanding how we can do this on station. We'll talk a little bit more today about how we're using the vision system to try to identify handrails and to do the different tasks that we want to do when we're moving around. When we send up legs, we hope to be able to do everything better. So one of the tasks we've done so far is we have a VelociCalc. It's a airflow measurement tool, and we've have one air vent really sort of close to us. It's still kind of far away, and so we can turn our body just the right amount to actually reach out and do the measurements, which is something the astronauts hate doing because you have to stay still for, you know, a lot of time. Robots love that kind of stuff. So once we're mobile, it'll be easy enough for us to climb around and do that sort of measurement anywhere. There's been a lot of technology offshoots from the project. So our partner General Motors has always been a big supporter of what we've been doing. They have a robot up in Warren, Michigan that they're researching for our incorporation into factories. And in fact, we have spun off something called the Robo Glove, which is robot that you wear. It's based on the hand technology from Robonaut, and it's an exoskeleton for your hands that basically you put it on, and it is a grip assist. And so if you're holding sheet metal or something like that, it causes a lot of injuries for factory workers because of that grip strength and carpal tunnel syndrome. So we've already spun off something that basically will allow you grab on, and then the robot takes a hold, and you can kind of completely relax your hands and fingers and just push a button whenever you want it to release. So the technology spin-offs that we get from this are amazing, and we have many more in queue, and it's a very exciting field to be a part of.
You have one for typing for me in my carpal tunnel?
Hopefully someday.
Are you surprised by the popularity of Robonaut? Does he have his own Twitter account
and Facebook feed and, you know, all that stuff? I'm not super surprised by it because I'm a total robot nerd. So I think that everybody should love robots. And, you know, there's something about a humanoid robot that really touches a person, that more than so even like the Curiosity rover, which has a huge following too, because it is also awesome. But you almost get a sense of this person belongs with us. This robot is almost like a person. And you can really give it a personality, maybe even more so than you can another object. So I'm not terribly surprised by that.
And if you'd like to find out what Robonaut's up to through Twitter, you can connect with him at @AstroRobonaut. And he's also Robonaut on Facebook. And Brian Blair is leading the team here in the Payload Operations Integration Center today as the pod. Busy at work, and that'll do it for us from here in Huntsville, Alabama. Now back to you at Mission Control in Houston.